Creative ideas can come from anywhere. But for me, nature has always been a fairly important part. I remember as a child being with my family as they took long drives on the flat prairies of Manitoba, with the enormous sky surrounding me on all sides. I thought about a certain kind of music that might be possible. Something simple, hanging in the air. Not sad, not happy, just being. A bit like your soul has left your body and it's observing you from above. Maybe from one of those telephone poles along the road. Now in my very different surroundings, a wetlands sanctuary in Hampshire, other kinds of ideas might appear to become part of a gradually evolving field of reference in the memory. I've always felt at home improvising, but teaching improvisation has always been challenging for me. It's a subject that's so philosophical that as soon as I say something about it, I can immediately see that the inverse is also true. It's a bit like looking through a telescope at a faint object in the sky. If you look at it too closely, you won't see it. You need to use peripheral vision. I might say to someone, you need to give your ideas more space. But then I see that maybe their ideas could be crammed even closer together with great effect. I'm gradually learning that improvising is more about psychology than anything. It's about following the different voices in your head. The objective voice and the subjective voice. The voice looking down from above and the voice from deep down below in the subconscious. I try to get people to learn to observe their own thought processes through experience.
Does anyone else have some comments? Maybe in some way comparing the two performances.
I think in a way, I actually prefer the
Of course you have to discuss things like harmony and counterpoint and form. But when actually improvising in real time, it's all about combining what you already know with what you're about to discover. To be honest, when teaching improvisation, I sometimes feel a lot of anxiety, occasionally frustration. I find myself thinking, I will never get through to them. Maybe it's all just a pipe dream of mine that everyone is inherently creative. Maybe I don't really have a clue how to teach this. More recently, this anxiety has been dissipating. Now I often feel a sense of shared experience in the room. And the feeling that I'm blessed to work with these uniquely gifted individuals. All searching for something. If musical improvisation can provide a more general life lesson, then maybe it's all about trust, allowing life to take its course. going with it. And that we don't always need to have our ducks in a row.
Wherever you are.